Welcome. In this video, we're going to talk about coding standards. I'll start off with what I'm showing on my screen. Now, the reason I want to show this is because this is definitely where we started in the very beginning. If you look on this far side on the left where it says, this is not the web. It may not be now, but it was at one point. In the very beginning, we just had one single way that we were going to access information, so we didn't have to worry about what our CSS or our HTML looked like or what kind of elements we used. There was no worry or concern about how content was going to be produced, so there wasn't a whole lot in terms of coding standards. But take a look at this image in the middle. This is the web. Well, that's truly what we're looking at today. A multitude of devices and a multitude of resolutions and connectivities. And there's so many different ways that we can access the information that it's vital that when we produce something, we're sticking to standards that are going to ensure that the content is consistently referenced in any compatible format. In other words, it's going to have to support the accessibility and the site performance and the responsive web design that we have available to us today. Because pretty soon, we're looking at something like the image on the far right-hand side, where this might be the web in the future. So every kind of device that's going to be able to render something needs to stick to a standard and one that we can all adhere to. So it doesn't matter what kind of device we have or the resolution, it doesn't matter what the connectivity is, it's going to be fairly consumed by every single individual. So with that in mind, we have a total of 17 standards that we employ in this class, and I'm going to talk about those in detail. Now you can find each of these coding standards in Blackboard. So if you just navigate into Blackboard, into the side panel, you'll find a link there for you. So let's get started with coding standard number one. This coding standard is referring to the basic HTML structure that every page has to have in order to be considered well-formed. You can see in the example of the coding standard one exactly how you should have your information laid out, starting with the first line should be your doc type, followed immediately by your name and date in comments. After that, you have a bare minimum requirement of making sure that you have an HTML element that includes a head element, that includes a meta and title element, and a body element that's going to include a header, a main, and a footer element. Make sure also that your HTML element has the language attribute set to English, and that your meta element has the char set attribute set to UTF-8. For coding standard number two, all lowercase letters must be used for all HTML elements, attributes, and CSS. Take a look at some of the correct and incorrect examples listed below, and make sure that you are evaluating what the difference is between an element, an attribute, and a selector. You'll notice in the first group, for the HTML elements, there's three correct examples and three incorrect examples. Followed thereafter by HTML attributes, what a few examples are that are incorrect and correct, and then after that, selectors in CSS. Coding standard number three, all two-sided elements must be closed. So all elements that contain content are considered two-sided, and they must have an associated tag. For example, a paragraph has an opening tag, the content in the middle, and a closing tag. And note that even if the HTML validator doesn't catch the missing closing tag, it is still a coding standard and it needs to be followed. Coding standard number four, all nested or child tags must close in the correct order. So if you have an element that's nested, make sure that you have it starting with an element and an opening tag, and then you create the opening tag of the nested element, making sure to close that nested element before closing the parent element. If you look in the example, there are three correct examples on how to work this out, and then there's also three incorrect examples, and then notice the incorrect placement of the elements listed inside there. Coding standard number five, all attributes must be enclosed in quotes. This is worded a little strange. It should say all attributes values must be enclosed in quotes. So an HTML attribute is going to provide additional information about the HTML elements that are placed in the opening tag of the element. And the attribute always has a value that's associated with it and needs to be encapsulated inside of quotes. So if you look down below, we have three correct examples and then also three incorrect examples. Notice, for example, in the paragraph, in the incorrect element, the ID is equal to level one and there's no quote marks around level one. So that would be an example of a coding standard violation. Now, coding standard number 6, no block level elements may be coded within paragraph elements, and you can see there's a list of all of the different block level elements. So you won't be able to start a paragraph and then use one of these elements inside of the paragraph. You could have the paragraph set outside of it, start before it or after it, but you just can't have any block level elements inside of your paragraph. So inside of the examples listed down below, we have 3 examples of how to correctly code and how to incorrectly code for this. Coding standard number 7. The alt attribute must be used and contain legible text in all of our image elements. So straight from the W3, the generic rule for the content of the alt attribute is use text that fulfills the same function as the image. Paraphrasing from the same source, not all browsers can or will display images and have been configured purposefully not to display them. Some visitors don't see images. They might be blind, colorblind, low-sighted, and so on. So they use screen readers or screen reading devices to read the alt text as a replacement to communicate the intent of the image. So it's of vital importance that when you are creating your alt attributes, you're putting in some very descriptive information that would replace the image if it wasn't available. Notice in the example below, we have 3 correct and 3 incorrect ways that we could express what our alt attribute should contain. Coding standard number 8, no spaces should appear around the attribute's equal sign. So an attribute that contains a value will need to have a value set in quotes, and you can't put a space before or after that equal sign. So notice in the example down below, we have 3 correct examples and 3 incorrect examples. Coding standard number 9, no deprecated elements or attributes are allowed. And here's an example of a few different types of deprecated elements, the big, center, and font elements, and deprecated attributes would be align, width, or height. So you can see down in the example below, there's a few more examples of elements that are considered deprecated, and then also some attributes that are considered deprecated. If you want a full list of all of the deprecated attributes and elements that are out there, you could always search Google for those, but by and large, you won't come across this very often, especially in this first semester, where most of the content that you're going to be creating has already been provided for you. Coding standard number 10. Site root pathways and drive letters are not allowed in any pathway in this course. So relative path links must be used at all times, and all file paths like shown below are going to be considered in violation of a coding standard. So if it starts with just a forward slash or a single period and a forward slash, or if it starts with something from your local machine, those are all examples of what you will not be able to do. Now in the future, outside of this course, you might choose to use this type of pathway for site root pathways. However, in this course, we are learning how to navigate through our directory from this source and not from a root source. So always make sure that you are not using a slash or a period forward slash to start any of your pathways. Coding standard number 11, all ID attributes must be unique in the same HTML document. So an ID attribute is a global attribute and it can be used on any element inside of your body, but you can only use an ID attribute once per page. You can't use that a second time. So notice in my example below, I have 3 correct ID attributes, and then below that, I'm showing an ID attribute with the same value paragraph used over and over again. So we wouldn't be able to do that. Coding standard number 12, ID, class, or name attribute values cannot contain spaces. So the class attribute can't contain a space. In the class attribute, if you have a space between, you're actually indicating a delimited list. So for example, class equals menu prices versus class equals menu space prices. Where the first one is a single class referenced, the second one is actually 2 different classes. You're referencing the menu class and the prices class. Elements can only have 1 ID attribute, and if you have a space in the ID attribute, it's being treated by the browser as non-conforming since it considers the space as part of the ID's value. And then finally, name attributes are often used in back-end processing, and it can be problematic if you have that space in there. So rather than cause issues down the line, we're just going to learn to not use it up front. So in the examples below, we have 3 correct ways to list our attribute value and then 3 incorrect ways. Coding standard 13, all of our ID, class, and name attribute values also need to start with a lowercase letter. So each value in the attributes for the ID class and name have to start with that lowercase letter for the best results that we can use. We're going to use that at the start. If you need to use more than one word, you can use what's called camel casing, where you're going to have the first letter as a lowercase and then each subsequent word starts capitalized. Some examples of camel case are this example, where the E is capital, or the next example, or even coding standards rock. In the example down below, you can see three correct ways and three incorrect ways to use this coding standard. Coding standard number 14, ID class or name attribute values cannot start with a number. Similar the same way that we don't want to have any of our values start with anything other than a lowercase letter, we don't want to have anything start with a number. So each value should always start with that lowercase and not like the ones listed in the incorrect section of our example down below. Coding standard number 15. Comments for name and date must appear on the top of every HTML and CSS document. So if your project has 6 web pages, each of those 6 web pages is going to need your name and date at the top. If you look in the example down below, you can see the HTML comments has my name and date. And then the incorrect one just says first name and last name. It doesn't actually have my name and date in there. It's just leaving the default value that was given to you when that assignment was created. Same thing with the CSS. You want to make sure that you're changing out what the default is and replacing it with your name and your date. Coding standard number 16. Only external style sheets are allowed. No inline or embedded styles will be used. CSS needs to be placed in an external document with a .css and a link element in the HTML head pointing to the correct file location. We're not going to be using any style elements, and we will not be using any style attributes inside of our HTML. With one exception, this semester, you will have one assignment where you're going to do that. And the only reason that you're going to do that is it's part of the learning process to see how it's used, and that would be for coding exercise number 3 that you'll be doing. After that and beyond that, we will not be using any inline or embedded styles. Notice in the example down below, how to correctly reference our external style sheet is listed in the head element. And then notice that the incorrect example shows an embedded style element, and then the inline is showing a style attribute. And number 17, all block level elements must begin on a new line. So all of them need to start on their own line. For a full list of all the block level elements, you can refer back to coding standard number 6 or use the W3C schools list for all of the block level and inline elements. In the example down below, you can see several correct and incorrect examples of how to do this. All right, now that's all of our 17 coding standards. If you have any questions on coding standards, please don't hesitate to ask.